To worship your name. Father Lord, we have given unto you what you cannot do for yourself. Father, whatever that we cannot do for ourselves, Father Lord, oh God, let it begin to manifest, to Lord.
Amen.
As we have manifest what you cannot do for yourself, for you, Father, accept it from us, O Lord.
Amen.
And bless everyone that are here.
Amen.
And bless everyone that will hear the sound of my voice. Father, let the sermons of today, Lord, be a blessing, O Lord, unto us.
Yes.
Let it change us. Let it correct all our ways, O Lord, O God.
Amen.
And to do only your will alone, so that we will prosper, O Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you,
Lord. In Jesus' marvelous name, I have prayed.
Amen. Amen.
Let's jam our hands together for Jesus. You can sing down and queen and king. Amen. I title my message today, Light. Amen.
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 When light comes, darkness comprehends not. When light comes, darkness vanish. When light comes, you begin to see well. When light comes, everything around you will be bright. When light comes, things begin to get better when light comes. And that light of God today, it will come upon our lives. Everyone that is in darkness, you cannot see the beauty around you. When light comes, you begin to see every beauty around you. But I'm here to tell you today, by the name of the Lord Jesus, that wherever your lights have been off for the blessing of God to locate, today's word will reactivate the light of God over your life.
Amen.
It's the light that the three wise men saw on the sky that made them to locate where Jesus are. If there be no light, they couldn't have find where Jesus Christ will be born. For the blessing of God to locate you, you need the light of God to shine. And that blessing that God Almighty sells, that the thoughts that he had for me and you is not of evil, it's of good. And we need that light for the favor of God to locate. We need that light for the blessing of God to locate. Because anything in darkness, nothing can locate them. When light comes, you begin to locate light. When some of people have people missing, what they do, they see the light, they begin to locate where light is. Amen.
Amen.
That is also what the incense also do. When you off light, incense, all of them will do what? They will be at peace on their places. But when you begin to do what? On the lights, you see that they begin to do what? Search for the light. And the blessing of God will search for you today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Please, can you just leave it the way it is? God bless you. Amen. Today, the blessing of God will locate us.
Amen.
Because the light of God has come over our lives. Many people did not know what this light means. When the light of God over your life is off, nothing good located you. But when the light of God is over your life, every good thing will locate you.
Amen.
When the light of God is upon you, your helper locates you. Because that light that God put in us that make man to receive us and have what compassion upon us and bless us. But when the light is not here, man will look at you. They will say it's like you did not exist before then. But when the light of God is in you, and they will see you and ask, what are you looking for? Or what did you want me to do for you? Because they have sought the light of God in what? In you. You appear to them as what? As light. When you appear to them as light, light do what? It do what? It attracts. When the light is not in you, when you appear to your what? To your helper, he does not see you. There are some people, the moment you enter into office, people notice that this person has entered. When you enter a place, you will see that people will notice that somebody has done what? Somebody has entered. There are some people, you will enter some place, nobody knows whether you enter or what, or not. There are some place when you are looking for a job, people will see you as light. It's like your light has already what? Attract them. Amen. When your light has attracted them and they keep you because they want to keep that light with them. Are you a light? Amen. Amen. The Bible says, we are the light of the world. If you are a light to the world, meaning anywhere you go, you must do what? Attract those that is around you. When you have light in you, the light of God in you, as our teacher was saying today, you will be not begin to appear before them and begin to count and say, this one, they are racist or not. When you are what? You know that you are light. When we compose ourselves where? When light comes, he brightens everywhere. That is the reason the Bible says, we are the light of the world. Wherever you go, did you brighten that place or you mess up that place? Where you go? Anywhere you go, will people see you and do what? And honor you? Wherever you go and you get there, you enter there, people honor you, meaning you brighten that what? That place. We need to do what? To compose ourselves wherever we go. Know it that you are a light of the world. People are looking at you. The moment you appear in any area, people worship you. Amen. People worship you. Please and please. Anywhere we go, let us appear as what? As lights. Let us remove that hatred from our hearts. Let's love ourselves first. This one is not loving others first. Let's love ourselves what? First. I begin to know that when you love yourself first, anywhere you go, you compose yourself. When you love yourself, those who did not love themselves, they behave anyhow wherever they go. Amen. But when you love yourself, wherever you go, you compose yourself. You want people to do what? To honor you. And you first of all honor the people that you do what? That you see by your words, by your character. A woman in my sister's town, he was telling my sister, he said, the way your sister composed himself, the way he appeared before people, he says it's different from Africa people that I have ever seen. Your presentation, the way you present yourself, it matters what? A lot. Anywhere you go, the way you do what? You present yourself. Our teachers were saying today, and it began to ring in my heart. He said, the way we do, people to say, can't you see them and they are like what? Black monkey. You see what they are doing. Amen. It's the way you do what? You compose yourself. My husband used to tell me, he said, behave in the way that people will do what? Will respect you. Don't just go there and throw yourself on the ground. Today we are going to pray. And some people, they like too much sorry. Yes. Amen. Amen. When you like too much sorry, people take you as what? As they are not even valuing you more than even what the sounds they see. It's the way you present what? Yourself. I was walking one day, a woman's just been washing me and come closer to me. He said, I am giving you this money. I said, madam, give to those who are in need this morning. And the woman's kind of begin to look at me. He said, why are you refusing? He said, I have a job. I am working. But there are people outside here that have not working. Those people need this your money, not me. And the woman was what? Surprised. Amen. What that mean? Don't just present yourself and some more people will just say, hey, money come bram. You have lifted yourself before that person. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
You know what you have done. You have lifted your what? Yourself before that person. What that money will do for you when you know that you have a job, you have the money. People want to fill their pocket. They don't care about other people. People are hard to give. Only receiving. Die. Amen. It is a time for you to go and see who thought that you are a black. When you see somebody that needed a course to complete his somebody and you have him bring it out. We entered into supermarket one day. Me and my sister, we were in the filler. This old woman come and he was counting coins, and the person that he was in the casa was not able to favor the woman. We bring out our money to do what? To complete the money of that woman. And the casa woman look at us. He said, is there any blood that can do this? I said, but you are 5-1 today. Our own, even though the woman's coins fall for ground, we go pull our neck, make the woman dance around, make it go, make we pick her. Amen.
Amen.
He said, a giver do what? Never lack. A giver never lack. It is time for you to see somebody. I said, I want to bless and I want to buy you what? A coffee. Just a, give them coffee. Some of us, the money will be there. When we enter into a place, we want to buy coffee and just drink. With the money will be there, we will say, die, un euro de favore, un euro de café, and you have the money in your pockets. Later you come and tell me that they are racist, they don't respect me. How will they respect you? Amen. This one I will tell you because I use my family and myself to preach to you because it's what happened in what I know. My senior brother was telling me, my junior one does not respect me. I said, brother, how will you want them to respect you? What have you done to them that they will think of that thing to respect you? You are not giving them any help and you are sending them message and you want them to run and go for you. Bye bye. Amen.
Amen.
Bye bye. If you are helping somebody, anytime that you are in need, that person is worth always there. Not only dime. You too, one day, still gives to somebody. Still give to somebody. You know why the telling people have given? Because they believe in that word of God strongly, that a giver never lack. It's not like that, it's other country. You know that the country that we are, they love God so much, whether you like it or not. They believe strongly in that word that a giver never lack. Even though that is 2 euros that remain their pockets, they will share it. We blacks, even though that 20 euro remain, we have 50 cent coins, we will not bring it out. If you cut for somebody, we finish. If you didn't cut for somebody, we also do more. It will also finish. But when you give to somebody, what you give to somebody, he begins to speak. Your seed begins to speak when you are not here. There are some people who will go to Nigeria and they enter any restaurants and whatever. They begin to display for the people they go when you don't know them before. But when they go, the seed when they sow, and then we come and we speak for them. Maybe that person you have filled even your enemy at that very day. But God can, because of what you did, that make that your enemy to save you in your world in danger.
Hallelujah.
He can say, oh, I didn't know that is this brother that you sent me to. And this brother, when we were in restaurants, see the way he declared for everyone. He says everyone should take 3 bottles. We drink and we enjoy ourselves. Please, let's leave this brother. And you will see that he's speaking for you. It is not you now that he starts speaking.
Amen.
It is not you. What are you giving? I have so many people, when they are sold into their enemy, because of the sins they sow, they will say, no, don't do this to this brother.
Yes.
Why? It's because of your seed. Amen.
Amen.
It's because of what you have sold. If you are a stranger man, the day that you before, he said, this thing, I bet none of your clear and come off the road. Amen. Appear as light wherever that you do what? You go. He said, we had what? The light of the world. And Jesus Christ says, I am the light. Those who serve me, the light is of what? Always with them. Behave. Wherever Jesus go, he was doing what? Good. And if you want to appear like Jesus as light, wherever you go, do good. Have you ever heard where the Bible says Jesus Christ uttered a word or an offense to somebody? No. Even when he met a woman that having 5 husbands, if we not here, we go talk, go be our word, our topic. We go talk, we go use nose talk, we go use hand talk, we go use leg talk. We go turn on somebody and say, come. Now 5 boyfriend, 9 they follow. Now 5. Tell me what it be your own game for inside. Amen. You never hear? No man will never forget. You don't forget. Amen. But when Jesus Christ saw the woman, he didn't say, hey woman, come here. You that have 5 wives, have 5 husbands, come, and begin to do what? And mess up the woman. No. First, he calls the woman attention. He tells the woman, he quotes the woman. He didn't go there and what? And injured the woman what? Insult. That is what many people are doing. They know where is your injury. That is where they will hit you.
Yes.
Stop it, repent. Remember the day will come. Your own injury, another person, we also do what? We also hit.
Yes.
He said, whatever that you sow, as we are saying today, that is what you will also do what? Whatever you bring out, that is what you will do what? You will receive. If you are here, mind your own what?
Business.
Amen.
Amen.
Last week we talked about run your own race. Run your race. Don't run another people's own. Run your race. Don't look at other people are not doing it well. I will not do it well. Run your own. Anything can happen at any time. Tomorrow might be too late for us. We thank God for today. That we sleep and we'll be able to do what? To wake up. It's a very word. Something when you wake up and see another bright new day, give time unto God.
Amen.
Give thanks unto God. Give time. There are people who sleep, never wake up. Never wake up. There are people who are prepared to do faster. They sleep, they never wake up to see that faster again. Our prayer is for us to hold and die. Because when I say you will not die, the truth is not what? In me.
Yes.
It's part of what? Of our life. Our prayer is for Father, you sent your holy begotten son to die as any age, so that me and you will not die what? As any age. So that ultimate death will not snatch us away from this wicked world. We will be old. He said, you shall see your children and children see. That is the word of God, not the word of man. That word of God will fulfill in our life in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
He said, we shall see our children and children see surrounding what? Our table. That is the word of God. Meaning, ultimate death will be far away from you. It will be far away from you. And here the Bible tells us that we are what? The light. Whatever that we do, let's do it what? In a way that people will see and say, oh, is this person a Christian? Those people that was before us, it's their character that made people to name them what? Christian, Christ-like. Are you behaving like what? Like Christ wherever you go? The way you talk to your friend, your fellow brothers and sister. Some of us we know the injury or whatever that that person do on secret, we know. If you want to talk, we are only referring to that thing, to bring that person, to use that thing to offend that person. Why are we like that? What are you gaining? What is your gain? Whatever you do to somebody today, tomorrow, another person, God will use another person to do it unto you, whether you like it or not. Our God is not a scam. It's not a scam. Any good thing you do, any thought of good you thought of your neighbor, a day will come, somebody will also thought of good of you. Please and please, let us be what? A light wherever that we go. Let's appear as what? As light wherever that we do what? We go. Let people begin to see us and begin to do what? Emulate us, our character, the way we do things, the way we talk. He matters what? A lot. Please and please. Are we ready to brighten the whole world? Amen. And God Almighty will give us the grace to brighten the whole world. Wherever you know that two people have a misunderstanding, when you get into there, being a light. Being a light. Don't ask to you that say, what do you do? This one, I feel not me. No, you come off for them. Amen. What are you not acting? Are you not acting as light or what? Amen. Love yourself first. When you love yourself, to love others is very easy.
Yes.
It's when you don't love yourself, when you see others, bitterness begins to come.
Yes.
When there is sweetness in you, when there is joy in you, when you are talking to somebody, somebody will be eating from the fruits of that joy that is coming out of you. But when you have bitterness in you, when you are talking, you begin to also feel the person that is in front of you with the bitterness. Every word that you say is an offense word.
Yes.
Sister, look at the way you be today. You don't get mirror before you come up for us. Look at your leg, even the shoe when you put for leg. You sure say not tight you and not be no better. You are just trying one way and the other to do what? To provoke the person. I tell one woman in my workplace, I said, I am very calm in spirit. I am very calm. But don't use a word to do what? To provoke me. Amen. Don't provoke other if you don't want other to do what? To provoke you.
Yes.
There are some ways. Whether you anoint, the anointing flow from your head, from head to toes, it can't flow, it can't be river.
Yes.
When somebody offended you, you will be provoked.
Yes.
Even Jesus Christ himself will be provoked when he was selling something in the front of his father's house. When he was provoked, he drove everything. That is the only place we saw that Jesus Christ was. He drove everything away.
Yes.
He said, this is a house of prayer, not a house of selling. Not the house of selling, not the house of doing osusu. It's the house of God. I pity some house of God. Is that the house of God? They are still doing what? Osusu. Please stop it. You can do that outside, not in the house of God. Not in the house of God. The house of God is where we come to do what? To pray. Not for selling and buying. You can choose other things or selling your things. Thank God that we have an open market in this country, that if you want to do business, you are free to carry your business to the open markets. Thank God for this 21st as our teachers were telling us today, that life continues to do well. We are living in a world, in a dynamic life that we have today. You can call someone and say, I am sending you this to whatever and ever to you. Anyone you like, please just contact me, then I will send it to you. Why in the house of God? Amen. Why in the house of God? Please, I know that we have business women among us. Please, I am telling you, and from today, this house is not for what? Business.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
If you want to sell something, send it to me, not after closing. There is a guiding behind us. You can go there. Amen.
Amen.
You can go there. This thing won't be stopped. Let the house of God come, that the house that we come to pray and seek the face of God and go home. When we want to do our business, we can do our business outside. Amen. Please and please. I am not against your business, but I don't want to please you to displease my God.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
That is meant for you. Amen. You can have everything that you want to sell. There is a guiding behind what? Behind us, you can do that. In the house of God, no. No, it's not, no. Amen.
Amen.
As we do, God Almighty will bless us. Be a light wherever that we do, that we go. Let's open our Bibles to the book of Exodus, Exodus 35, verse 8. Are you keeping your light burning?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Exodus 35,
Exodus 35, verse 8.
And Saul, for the man, life, and his eyes for anointing oil, and for the sweet incense.
Amen. The Bible is telling us today, there is an oil that kept our lights what burning. What are those oil that kept our lights burning? It by hearing the word of God. Amen. When you hear the word of God every time, every day, he kept that light what burning. He said, an oil for the light. Amen. And a spice for the anointing oil and for the sweet incense. Today we are going to pray that what we keep our lights burning, it will not off.
Amen.
That our oil will not run dry.
Amen.
The oil that is making our lights continue to work, to be lighting, it will not got finished. There are some roads that you will pass. Even when they say that nobody should pass this road, but when you appear as light, people will favor you and say, allow him to go.
Yes.
Allow him to pass. There are some people, even all your documents and whatever is still complete, they will see all you and find one excuse and the other. According to one program that I saw, he said, because your every document that is Nigeria is too correct, he said, because it's too correct, we arrest you. Amen. Because they ask you driving license, you bring a command. Particular of the car, you bring a command. Everything, you bring a command. He says, sir, everything you're correct. For this one, because everything is correct, you're under arrest. In my country, that kind of thing they happen. Amen. And may you know now, there are some people, they will say, even though the document correct, not correct, they will say, go, pass. Amen. For you to know. And our lights, the oil that will make our life continue to be burning, for us to achieve the blessings of God, it will never go down in Jesus' name.
Amen.
There are some blessings. Everything of the blessings of God, there is the light of God that will attract what? That blessing. There is a light who will do what? Who will attract that blessing. And the Lord God Almighty, our light will never went off in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let us now open to the book of Job. Job 22. Job 22 verse 28.
Amen.
Amen.
Verse 28. Thou shalt also decree a thing, that it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon the ways.
Amen. He said that light shall do what? That shine upon the way. Meaning, when the light come, the way for you to follow, and God will direct you by the light of who? Of God. He said, whatever that you do, what you put your hands to do. Whatever that you are doing, when the light of God does not shine upon you, you can never gain anything as we are saying today. You need the light. Say somebody, you need the light.
You need the light.
And the light of God will shine upon your life today.
Amen.
Amen. The light of the Lord God Almighty, it will shine upon our lives. And we will never regret of coming to this country.
Amen.
When the light of God is upon our life, we don't regret. Because anything that we are in need, it comes to us. Today we are going to pray as I said it before. When the Lord is with us, who can be against you? because God has decided to be for us. We know that nobody can do what can be against us. Let's look at the book of Job, that the same Job 9 verse 17. I want to use these words to advise every one of us.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Job 9 verse 17. For he breaketh me with a tempest and multiplied my wound without cause.
Amen. Let me tell you this. There are things that will happen to any of us. People, please don't rush into conclusion. Please don't rush into conclusion. Something happened to a man. Somebody will say, oh, that person is sick. Maybe not the thing we do hide. Now he goes on. Amen. Or maybe not the sin where his mother committed. Oh, maybe not the sin where his wife committed. Now it happened. Now it can catch him. Amen. Please and please. The book of Ezekiel 18 tells us, it says, everyone will suffer for his own sin. I will not suffer for the sin of my parents. I will not suffer for the sin of my husband. Also, husband will not suffer for the sin of his wife. When something happens, some person, you're just talking, oh, it's the sin of the wife. I say, you don't even know what you are talking. You don't know. I say, have you not heard the Bible says that everyone who sins will suffer for his own sin? Amen. And no one we suffer for the sin of another person. Don't just rush into what? Into conclusion. God can make something to happen to somebody just to see the reaction of that person. He said, although that sickness will be there, but I know that God will not use this sickness to suffer me, to take my breath away from me. Rush into conclusion when you see somebody is going into more challenging. If you are a light, what you do, you jump the person what in prayer. Not pick your phone and say, don't you hear what had happened to that brother or to that sister? As you are dropping your phone, just believe that thing will also come back to you. Stop what? Stop lying. He said, the Lord hath breaketh me with tempest and multiply my wound without what? Without no case. Meaning it's not the wrong that he does that makes God to do what? To do that. Amen. Amen. It's not the wrong. Please and please, let us be what? Be very careful of how we conclude over matters. Let's go on to 18.
Verse 18. He will not suffer me to take my breath, but fillet me with bitterness.
Amen. He said, he will not suffer me to do what? To take my breath away from me. The Lord will not take us our breath away from us in Jesus' name. Amen. And that suffering that you are passing through, that is the bitterness. He said it will never end your life. He said the Lord is still what? Is still with you. Let's go on to 19.
Verse 19. If I speak of strength, lo, he is strong. And if of judgment, who shall set me a time to breathe?
Amen. He said, if I speak strength, behold, he is mightier. Amen. And this God that we are talking about, here the Bible is telling us that he's mightier. Whatever has happened to you, just give thanks unto him. He knows what is happening unto you. Amen. When your time of delivering is come, and today is the time of your delivery. Amen. You will be delivered. I don't know what man and woman have used to be mocking you. But the Lord God is at home today to deliver us. Let's quickly run to that the same book of Job. Job 28. We are going to take it from verse 4. Job 28 from verse 4.
On verse 4. The flood breaketh out from the inhabitants, even the waters, forgotten of the food. They are dried up. They are gone away from men. Verse 5. As for the earth, out of it cometh bread, and under it it turned up as a wildfire.
Amen. He says, although those things, those water, when we are talking about waters as we saw yesterday, it's a life. Amen. It's what? A life. Many men are far from God, from their hearts. Please, let's come closer unto this God. Amen. As we do, the God Almighty, He will bless us.
Amen.
He will never forsake us.
Amen.
He will never abandon us. Yesterday, the Bible was telling us, He said, when men hurt you, don't cry in the front of those men who hurt you. He said, pour your cry unto God.
Yes.
Amen. When men talk whatever they want to talk of you, hurt you with words or whatever, don't ever cry in the front of that man or that woman.
Yes, sir.
When you go home, pour your tears unto God,
Amen.
Not unto man. Many people will laugh at you, and you begin to cry in their presence. Don't do. When you go home, that thing they used to laugh at you, pour that cry unto God.
Yes.
Hannah will be hurt by his own words, his own deeds. He didn't begin to cry at the front of Penina. No, he didn't do. What did Hannah did? Hannah says, Father, I know that I have no children. But Penina, you are laughing at me. He didn't cry. He ran to the house of God. He began to pour his tears unto God, not unto Penina. What is that that has been bothering you? That men shine on you, they will do their nose for you. What are those things that they are saying? You are saying, asking God, trusting God for. And those things are not coming. And men have used it to laugh you. No one, no two, no three. I say, rise on your feet. Rise on your feet. What is that situation that are saying to be dear? And men are reminding you of it. Anytime they see you laughing, you are rejoicing. They will begin to go there and hit on that wall, on that wound. If you are a Christian, you have no documents and you are laughing, people begin to bring out their document. Not that nobody asked them to bring out their document. It's just to remind you that you have no documents. You are what? You are not buying a land. The Lord God Almighty, who know how to bless in people, He said, I will bless you and we added no sorrow unto it. The Lord will bless somebody today.
Amen.
He will add no sorrow to your blessing.
Amen.
The Lord will bless somebody. He will add no sorrow unto it.
Amen.
He blesses Solomon. And no water enter into coconuts, and you will not know how God, this blessing will come. But I am here to tell you, because of the light of God that is upon you, your helper will locate you. When your helper locates you, what you could not do for 5 years, and your helper will do it for you just under 1 week.
Amen.
Just under 1 week. What you cannot do for yourself for 5 years, somebody is going to receive a blessing, something that you have been searching for good 5 years. You are not able to do this. You thought that shaft had been closed. The Lord is saying, I am the one that open that no one closes. He said, who is able to open the scroll? He said, but nobody. But he said, I am that I am. He's willing to open the scroll. And the Lord is about to open somebody's scroll. I don't know what you have started that you cannot finish. And the Lord is at home today. And so use your helper to open that scroll for you. Our Lord is able to do. He's able. What you cannot do for yourself, for the good 5 years you have been struggling for that thing, and it's not coming. He said, under a week, he said, that thing will come. Just under a week, he said, it will be completed. Our God can never lie. When he sees something and it comes to pass, he can never lie. You are going to lift up your right hand unto God. Unto God. You know what you have been searching for. You know all your heart desire. You know your need. The Lord is breathing upon somebody. As you lift up your hands to God, the Lord is breathing that thing your heart desire. He's breathing it upon your life. Is it document? Is it job? Is it wife? Is it husband? Is it financial breakthrough? Is it children? Whatever be your need, the Lord is breathing it upon you right now.
Amen.
He's breathing it upon you. He's breathing it upon you. He's breathing it upon you. He said, when the Lord breathes upon a man, we come to an existence. When the Lord breathes those things in your life, those things will begin to exist in your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Yeah.
You will begin to exist in your life.
Amen.
I don't know your cry, but God knows your cry. He knows it, that you have been crying for those things. And those things have not come here. And you'll be about to give up. You'll be about to even assassinate yourself because of those things have not come here. I am here to announce to you today, the Lord is breathing this upon your life. He's breathing this upon your life. He's breathing this upon your life. He's breathing this upon your life. He shall come to manifest. Shall come to manifest.
Amen.
Don't kill yourself. The Lord is at home, and those things will be manifest.
Amen.
When He manifests, you will testify.
Amen.
Of a truth that the God that you call upon, that you thought that He has failed you, is not a scam.
Oh.
It's not a scam. He never lied. He is the God that never lose control. He never lied. You have been calling upon this God. You thought that God had closed your chapter. No, God loves you. He said, this is the appropriate time for me to show myself to you strong. That I am not the one who sleeps. I am not slumber. When I see the thing, it comes to pass. The Lord has sealed our hearts. And we bring it to come to pass. In Jesus' name, I am praying.
Amen.
You are still going to pray for yourself. And say, Father, whatever that will make me to sleep, not to wake up, Baba, let it be far away from you.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, yeah. heart's failure? Overthinking.
Yes.
What making the heart's failure? There are some people who are still taking these strong drugs. Please stop it. Amen. There are some people. Please, the way you are is good. You that know how to talk, stop go and telling people that go and sleep, you are too fat. Amen.
Amen.
I am okay the way I am.
Yes.
If I am fat, I didn't fat for your body.
Yes.
If I am slim, I didn't slim for your body.
Mm-mm.
People are taking drugs just because they want to get slim. And the doctor says those drugs, he kills the heart.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Please, and please. Even some African people are taking drugs. People will tell you that it's natural. It is not natural, my dear. Amen. I was telling doctor, I said, doctor, people are testing drugs. He said, please tell them not to buy any drugs to sling. Those drugs, it affected their hearts. He gave problems to their hearts. Please tell them. And people are doing it. And when you are not young, you are taking it. When you are getting to 40, 41, 42, 43, when you sleep, you know where you say, wish don't come. Come. Amen. Wish come. Please and please. There are some people you will eat overfeeding. You cannot get up again. The next you your rot or your birth here. It affects the heart. Amen. Because when those food does not digest, it making the heart to be working hardly. And we now when we day here, you know the situation that we are. We are overlapped the heart with all we want to have it all. We can't see it, Joanna. The food not digest. We still rot on our bed. The heart now, instead of the heart to be resting, it will not be what? Bless us.
Amen.
Please and please. If anybody is telling you that you are too sleep, you are too slow, push the person away from your front.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Tell the person, please, anytime you tell me that I am too fat, if not because the light of God is upon me, I for show you darkness. But because of the light of God is upon me, let me show you light. Come off of my front. Amen. Because nobody will get the body. So intimidating people.
Yes.
So intimidating people. When you not sleep, your nyash big, and you are this side, go this side, and you are this side. Please, don't intimidating people. Do you think that it's everybody that likes it, sleeping?
At all.
Let me tell you, my dear one thing, a secret something I want to tell you. All men like fat women. The slim one, they want to use it to play. Amen. But if you are slim, me too, I am slim. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Me, I am slim. I take my own as well because of my head. I am okay. Because of my head. Even because I want to get even more slimmer than this because of my head. Okay? Please don't come and intimidate me that I am too slim. Don't come and intimidate me that I am too fat. Just leave me the way I am.
Yes.
Amen. As we do, God Almighty, we bless you.
Amen.
We are still going to pray one prayer for this land of Italy that we are. That the Lord God Almighty, the light of God, let it shine upon the land of Italy. Open your mouth and begin to declare it upon the land of Italy. Let the light of God shine upon the land of Italy. If the land of Italy is good, and we that is inside the land of Italy, we will also benefit from it. Father, let the light of God shine upon the land of Italy. Let it shine. Let your light shine upon the land of Italy. In Jesus' marvelous name, we are praying.
Amen.
that you are baptized by water, please let come quickly. Amen. To time with the Lord. Let nothing stop us. Amen. As we do, God Almighty will bless us. Please, just by 2-3 minutes, we are done. Amen.
My God,
please, we are still in the service. It's not our time to discuss or whatever. This is my body. Shall be far away from that body. Is there anywhere we have wrong so that we will not eat your body into contamination? Father, have mercy on us.
Amen.
Forgive us all our sin.
Amen.
As we eat your blood, O Lord, it shall be a blessing unto us, not a curse.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we give thanks. Now you can take the bread. You see, in the same manner, he poured out the wine. He said, "This is my blood. As you drink, remember me." Forgive those who have hurt you. Lift up the blood of Jesus and give time unto God. If you know truly you are holding this cup in your hand and you are having somebody in your heart, forgive before you take it. So that it will be a blessing in your body, not a curse. Because he said you cannot drink for the table of God and also for the table of the demon. Father, Father, we give thanks unto you. We thank you for your blood. Let your blood cleanse every unclean things in us, O Lord. Both in and out. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have given thanks. Now you cannot take the blood of Jesus. Amen. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. That is the kingdom, and the power of the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Before I say surely, do we have any new member among us? Before we say surely.